Hi, everybody. I wanted to share something that I created recently. It's a custom GPT bio to schema. It's specifically trained to turn your author bio into an EEAT-optimized person schema with the goal of doing SEO a little bit better and highlighting the expertise of the subject matter experts that you work with. Often, creating a person schema from scratch can be really difficult, but hopefully this will help you scale the effort. So I thought, speaking of subject matter expertise, what bigger subject matter expert is there in the world of SEO than Aleyda Solís? So I'm going to demo this with Aleyda's bio. I pasted this from Aleyda's website. So let's see what the GPT comes up with. I've trained it into a 10 steps process where it tries to identify the most essential information in the bio for the schema, and then identifies what's the information that's missing. So the thing that's going to do now, and that's already started doing, is it's asking me for the information that's not yet there. So we're going to get all of that info that it is providing and figure it out and bring it back, see what type of person schema it creates. Okay, so I'm back after a pretty intense session of stalking Aleyda. I'm so sorry, Aleyda. But I have all the information that the custom GPT requested, which is her personal website, headshot, image, articles that have been written about her. This was some heavy stalking. And then some links to Aleyda's social media profiles and publications. I checked that in her bio, she highlighted her work with Moz and Search Engine Land. So I looked for those and added those in. Now, something that I'm seeing already is that the GPT hasn't asked me for a lot of information about Oriente, which is where we've said that Aleyda works, nor has it asked me information about Aleyda's books or Aleyda's awards, which is something that is part of its training material. So that strikes as interesting to me. I'm curious to see what the next steps are going to be after I provide this information. Oh, straight onto JSON files. Okay. Okay, it's making up some information. That's fine. So for example, in there, instead of looking for Oriente's website, it just added Aleyda's website in there. I love that it's making a description. Yeah, the alumni, it could be better. Like it could be the credential category degree. I believe it could be more specific onto a master's degree. And when you're showing the college or university, you could add a same as property to give it a little bit more of weight and help disambiguate the entity that you're referring to exactly by using a more clear common ID. Oh, I'm curious to see what's going to do on the subject of section. In the training information, I've told it to extract the headline and use the headline as the property headline, but I can see that it's not doing that at all. So it is including it, which is not bad, but it's not really going the extra mile, going the full way that I expected it to. Anyway, I'm criticizing my own work at this point. Should have probably started with a smaller schema. She's done so much. I feel like I would need a lifetime to write out all of her accomplishments into a JSON file. But, you know, we're trying. And done is better than perfect. So if we're trying to do this at scale for a publication or a site with several different authors, this can really accelerate your implementation and go from having nothing to pretty much having a working person schema that you can improve over time. And yeah, that would be all for me. I'm going to now launch this tool for everybody, and please let me know any feedback that you have.